Okay, so in the previous lecture, we were looking at the cross point complexity of a strictly non blocking network. So, what we did was we actually have taken n is equal to p by q kind of expression, and we have got I think q and 2q minus 1, that was the dimension in which every input switch actually was designed in that fashion. And total p number of switches were there. Okay, and then there were middle stage switches. Each one of these switches is a p by p configuration. And there were 1 and 2 q minus 1 switches in the middle stage. And symmetrically there was a output side switches were also there. So, there were q outputs or q ports from coming from each port, and their number was again the p. And what we did was, the way it has been derived, that p is equal to q is taken as root of n, okay, and p into q will be n. That was the condition I think with which we are trying to build up the cross point, number of cross points which are going to be there in the strictly non blocking switch, and we are trying to build up a recursive construction. Next step, what I did was, I took this switch which was having q inputs, 2q minus 1 outputs. I said this can be equivalently represented by a q by q switches. So, number of outputs will be now q plus q, if you put them together, these are 2q. So, not 2q minus 1, but 2q. I can equivalently represent this thing by this. This also means the middle stage switch, now there will be a modification, you will get 2q here. We will also get 2q switching elements, switching boxes of switching elements are also going to be there in middle stage. Each one of them now can be equivalently represented by 2q by q switches. Okay, so in turn, what is the total number of switches which we will be requiring for total number of cross points if I want to compute? So, this is number of, the way I say, the cross points in 2 raised to the power n. Okay, that is the way n was defined, and I had also taken that n is 2 raised to the power l, that l belongs to an integer, or I can call it a natural number, it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, it cannot be negative, so I can very well write it as a natural thing. Okay, with these conditions.
So, why we are calculating f raised to 2 to the power, f of 2 raised to power n, what we have to realize, we started with under root n cross n block switch. Why we want to realize n cross n?
Because for this I will be able to solve the cross point, this expression for the number of cross points. I am just building up a recursive relation.
That's true.
Okay.
But recursive relation with a basic building block, that will be terminating point. Any recursion we solve, some of the basic condition, and for the general purpose n. N in function of basic.
See, ultimately I should be able to reach to f2. F2 cannot be split any further. Okay. Idea is that. So, if the 2 by 2 switching block has to be what we call the basic building block, I am just creating the whole switch with nothing but 2 by 2 switches, which is a basic element, which we have also done for rearrangeably non-blocking. So, in that case, number of cross points required in a, for a 2 by 2 is 4. Okay. So, for example, what we did for rearrangeably non-blocking, I said 2 log 2 n minus 1, those many number of stages will be there. Each stage will contain n by 2, 2 by 2 switching elements. So, this is the total number of switching elements required for a switching rearrangeable non-blocking switch, and each switch will require only 4. So, this is the total number of cross points required in a rearrangeable non-blocking switch, what we get from flip and do it theorem. But this was on the condition that n is 2 raised power something. Otherwise, I could not have come to this condition. There will be some f3 or something. There will be some constant which will ultimately come. But this will be more or less true for all cases. This log 2 comes because of that. But we know it is going to be logarithmic. What will be base, that will be different. I can do also 3 by 3. I need not always do 2 by 2. So, while creating recursive construction of a rearrangeable non-blocking switch, I was every time dividing by 2. I started with 2 by 2 basic element. I can do it with 3 by 3 also. So, maybe you will have log of base 3 something n in that case, and you will have f of 3 which will be 9, which is a constant. N by 3 does not, these constants does not matter. This will become n by 3, this will become 9, log 3 n. This is still a constant, minus 1 you can forget. Ultimately, it will be n log n. That will be the complexity. Okay, so it does not matter. So, what log, base log you take does not matter actually. I think same is also true here. I am anyway solving for 2 by 2 here, but expressions will come out to be same, but this way it is simpler. So, what we will have is, we I think reached at this particular point that f of n. So, n is 2 raised power n actually, small n, will be, I will be requiring p number of elements, and p is 2 raised power n by 2. Okay. So, in total 2p q by q, q switching elements, and q is has been taken as root of n. Okay. So, I will require,
sir, excuse
here.
Me, sir, how it's 2 of p in here, because here the input number of switches is p, 2q minus
this
p.
One,
no, in the input stage,
input q stage,
p. It is,
yeah, p switches, so one is coming from, in this switch, one output port coming from each one of them, so there will be p inputs.
So that is okay, sir. That in calculations, this 2 into 2 power n by 2, we are taking, that how is that 2 factor coming from?
I am coming to that. So, there are how many 2 raised power n by 2 switching elements?
Sorry.
Now, each q by 2 q switch is implemented in this fashion.
Okay.
So, I require twice of them.
Okay.
So, total number of elements which I require is 2 p here, which is nothing but these many elements of size q by q, q actually, q by q is this basic element. Q also happened to be 2 raised power n by 2. Okay. So, you require these many number of elements, basic element sizes 2 raised power n by 2 by 2 raised power n by 2. Here, how many elements will be required? You require 2 q elements. Each one of them is p by p type, this is nothing but p by p only. Okay. So, again you require 2 into 2 raised power n by 2, even in this stage. Similarly, on this stage, because this, you just take the mirror image of this, 2 q inputs and q outputs, I can also implement the same switch.
Sir, is there any particular advantage of implementing the switch like that?
This one.
Huh?
Actually, I require this much. I require q input ports and 2q minus 1 outgoing ports, and it has to be strictly non-blocking. That is the only condition. I am trying to remove one, I am trying to duplicate, so that everything, what I require is basic building block is this, just by using this I can create a strictly non-blocking switch of n by n, 2 raised power n by 2 raised power n. So I can build up a recursion formula actually. It was done for that purpose. So in turn, 2 here, 2 into 2 raised power n by 2, 2 into 2 raised power n by 2, same here. I require in total 6, and the switch which I require is 2 raised power n by 2 by 2 raised power n by 2, this box which I have drawn. So I can write the cross point complexity of this as this. So I have got the recursive relation now. Now if this relation is true, I can very well write this also, same recursion holds. I can keep on doing it iteratively a large number of times. I am just completing it so that now this is going 2, 4, n by 2, n every time. The power itself is also going. That is why I have written 2 raised power l. N is equal to 2 raised power l, where l goes as an integer. That is the reason why it has been done that way. Yeah. So I can keep on putting up the values, taking from the lower one to the upper one and so on. Ultimately what you will get is a series. So how much value? This is 2 raised power 0, this is 2 raised power L minus 1, 2 raised power L is N, okay. So 6 raised power L, see N by 2 is this. 1 is 2 raised power 0. Total L terms have to be there. So I am counting the terms based on this index. 1, 2, something. So there has to be L terms, that is why 6 raised power L has to be there. Okay. So that is the way you can remember how many terms. Otherwise, usually it becomes difficult for some people. So need not remember it, you can derive it from here itself. And f of 2 is 4, does not matter whatever we say, this is a constant, some constant k. So 6 raised power l, whatever is this series, what is the value of this? So it is 1, which is 2 raised power 0, 2 raised power 1, 2 is square. So I am talking about whatever is there, this particular series. And this is nothing but geometric progression. You can very well find out the sum. So first value, whatever is the ratio, 2, total number of terms, minus 1, 2 minus 1, 2 raised power L minus 1. 2 raised power L is nothing but N. N minus 1. So this will be this value is nothing but n to the power n is nothing but capital N, the size. Okay, 6 to the power L has to be now sorted out. So this is how much?
6.
6. So everybody knows by basic elementary mathematics. So 6 to the power L is L log 2 6 okay. I can very well write this is this 2 to the power L whole raised power log 2 of 6. 2 to the power L is how much? This N, and from here N is nothing but log 2 of capital N. So I can write here so in turn now log 2 of 6 is 2.58. So you will get N by 2 log 2 of N 2.58, whatever is F2 is a constant. So your cross point complexity is this for a recursively non blocking switch. So now let us go back and recall what we did so far. So there is a non-recursively built strictly non-blocking. What was the cross point complexity? When we went for recursively built, rearrangeably non-blocking, I got this, and when it is recursively built strictly non-blocking, and of course now the question arises, can I have still something better than this or not? Because I just made an estimate, okay, whatever I am going to compute, cross point complexity cannot be worse than this. I can still find out something which is better than this at least. It gives us a bound. Okay. So can I build up something which is strictly non-blocking and have better complexity than this? So that is a next question. And of course, this again was answered by Cantor. CANTOR, and he came up with the idea of Cantor network. Now this also leads to a fundamental method by which you can make almost any switch as strictly non-blocking or rearrangeably non-blocking. I have actually mentioned this fact many times, so I will just state the same fact here and then we will move ahead. So idea is this, I have a switch. It is now connecting to many other switches actually in the middle stage. Okay. So far these ports are higher than this, or these ports are higher than this, both these conditions have to be satisfied. Blocking can only happen because of the interconnection. So it is possible if I keep on expanding on these intermediate stuff, keep on adding more and more. At some point I will become strictly non-blocking. So Cantor actually take up the same idea ultimately, but he could build up the proof that was the thing. What he said, okay, I can actually have, what he did, he took a rearrangement to non-blocking network, but he was not using any rearrangements. Okay, he used something called Benz network and many of them. And for any every input, he started using something called demultiplier. Actually, it's not a, it's a switch, 1/n switch. So one port is connecting here and one port connecting here for every input port. He does that. So what is actually happening is, earlier if it is only a rearrangeable non-blocking switch, I require only one single Benz network. This is again basically 2x2 basic elements, 2 log 2 and minus 1 stages, and connection is the way we build up the recursive rearrangeable non-blocking switches, same block. So if I don't use these demux, all input ports are only directed to here, and they are also again directed to, in same fashion, here. So forget everything else. So all these inputs are directed here and they are directed here, it is a rearrangeable non-blocking switch, because this can be rearranged always to set up the connection. And that is Benz network if basic element is 2x2 and with 2 log 2 and minus 1 switches, stages actually. So what he did is, he kept on using this multiplexers. Now remember their complexity of these multiplexers is clearly decided by number of ports here and number of these switching elements, multiplication of these two, nothing more than that. Okay. He said, if I keep on increasing this number, at some point of time, when this number is going to reach to a certain threshold, I should be able to set up a path without disturbing any earlier connection. It should be possible all the time. So the whole theory is, whatever he did was, he just find out what is the value of this m, minimum value of m required, so that you can always set up the path without disturbing earlier one. So there is no rearrangements. And once you know, you can find out the complexity of all these switching elements. So 1 by m switch, 1 by m switch, m by 1, m by 1, and total n such switches actually. And use that, the complexity of these will be lower and complexity of these will be higher. For this already complexity is O n log 2 n. For this the complexity is n into some this particular factor multiplied by 2 if you take this one also consideration. Complexity of these switching elements will be always lower than this. So this is what will decide. And ultimately what he did is, he proved that m, when m will take a value of log 2 n, that time this particular network will become strictly non-blocking. And how this log 2 m comes, I will tell. But when m reaches log 2 n, the switch will be strictly non-blocking. That was the Cantor's contribution. And once this condition is there, your complexity is n log 2 n for this one. This is a complexity because of the middle stage elements, complexity because of this n log 2 n for these elements, and this being done 2 times, this is lower order than this, so I can neglect whenever I am computing complexity. So ultimately you will end up in getting a complexity which is this.
How the square thing came, because the Benz network is n log n.
Benz network is n log 2 n, and number of switching elements, number of Benz network, m is log 2 n. So multiply by that. So it is not log 2 n is for 2.58, but log 2 n square. That is a bound now for strictly non-blocking switch. We still don't know whether a bound can be still further reduced. Can it be 1.8? Maybe, but nobody knows. But the bound is certainly not more than 2. It is currently 2 n log 2 n square. And for rearrangement norm, it's n log 2 n. The power is 1 actually, log 2 n power 1. So somewhere in between, actually the best possible value will exist, but currently known best possible value is 2.
It's
for unicasting, not for multicasting. That is true. It's only for unicasting. I think that is true for whatever we have done so far. We have not taken any case for multicasting. Multicasting, the problem is tricky actually. And as I was mentioning once, that you can actually use graph theory, basic principles, to do that. So one way, for example, if I am looking for Clausius network or the Pauls matrix, I was trying to mention that if you look at the input switch as a node, output switch as a node, okay. So these are bipartite graph. So these are the input nodes, these are the output nodes. I can set up a connection between them. I am creating a link. So link can be there between these. I can create a link here. I can create a link here. But total number of links which can emanate from a switch, that has to be controlled. So each one of them has to follow a different middle stage switch. So what I have to ensure is, if I start coloring these links itself, I have to ensure that at any edge, at any node, all the links which are emanating from a common node has to have different colors. They have to choose different middle stage switches. Same has to be true here. And total number of colors which are required to do the coloring of edges, what's the minimum value required actually? So if you can prove that, that number will tell you what, how many middle stage switches are required. If I can put say color X here, and same color can be used here, I can use same middle stage switch, that's what it means actually. But between these two, I cannot use same color, because there is a, they actually have a common node. They cannot have same color, they have to have different color. They have to be routed through different middle stage switches. So find out the minimum number of colors. And that, I think, theorem is known as Hall's theorem in case of graph theory. But what the way we have done it is slip and do it theorem. But technically results are same for a rearrangeable non-blocking switch. So coloring problem, actually you can convert it to a edge coloring. This is not a node coloring, this is an edge coloring problem. And from there you can actually solve, find out the connections. But anyway, since we have already done through slip and do it, I am fine with this. Even for multicasting, this will be true. That's multicasting cannot be handled by this edge coloring, it's done through a node coloring problem. So what happens is, a connection itself, so connection between this node and this node, this connection is counted as a node. Okay. And if two nodes, one particular connection 1, 2, and then the similar connection is there, 2, 3 connection is there, if they have a conflict, so I represent this thing by a node and this connection has a conflict, so I create a link. So for one particular connection, all the connections which can have conflict with this will be the neighbors actually. Any node which is not the neighbor, this does not have a conflict with this. And then I can design what we call node coloring problem. No two neighboring nodes should have the same color, because they are having conflict with each other when a connection is going to be set up. So this is in a different domain. That's what actually is going to be used for multicasting resolution. How to set up the paths for multicasting. So coming back to the Cantor network, how to prove this? Okay. So I have given the result. Now let's start proving it. So we have to understand what is a Bain's network first. I will just draw that. Each one of us know. So I have taken a 8x8 Bayes network. So same thing will repeat. I am assuming that you can visualize the same drawing repeated multiple times. That's what is a Bayes network. So this box is that. So this guy can connect to. So we call this as the first stage all across all the Bayes networks. So how many nodes it can reach? Compute that. So there are total m nodes, m switching stages. It can reach one here, second here, third here, mth here. So in the first stage, the nodes which can be reached by an input is m. It does not matter whether connection has been set up or not, but I can always set up a path till this particular switching element or this switching element, this switching element, because if this is not connected, all these lines are free. Once these are free, I can always set up a path till that particular node at least. From first to second stage now will come. Now if this, you look at this particular switch, this also has second input here. In worst case, now all these second inputs in all these switching elements 1 to m, all of them will be connecting to the second input port here. Worst case scenario, suppose a already path has been set up for this second guy. So this path will be either connecting this first one here or first one here or first one here, and this has to be routed to the second stage. So it can either take this, or in the next one the same first second element lines, or in the last one first and second. Only one of them can be taken, all of them cannot be. So this input should be able to reach how many nodes in the second stage? Twice of this number, because I am able to go to m first stage switching elements, twice of that minus 1 which has been occupied by the second incoming port. So A2 which I can reach is 2 of A1 minus 1. Similarly, now it reaches to A2 number of switching elements. All these switching elements are able to further now reach to how many? Twice of A2. But all those elements, the second stage here for example, is able to reach from here, is able to come even from here, from two more, this one and this one. So these two also, in every one of them, will be able to reach these. In worst case scenario, these also have been set up already. So actually, which is the number of elements in the third stage to whom it can reach is 2A2 minus 2. If you go to A4 similarly, unfortunately I have not drawn that bigger diagram, okay, because it goes 1, 2 and third stage is this, and that is the last stage. So I need to only go to log 2 n stage actually, not any further. So if it is a larger dimensional, A4 will exist, okay. So A4 will be twice of A3 minus how many? 2 square. it is 2 1, it is 2 raised to power 0. In general, our expression will be AK twice of A raised to power K minus 1 minus 2 K minus 2. This K cannot be larger than log 2 n. This K cannot be larger than log 2 n. That is the maximum you can have from the input side. So, depending on whatever be the value of m, these many nodes or switching elements I should be able to reach. Okay. So, once you understand, you actually have cleared a big hurdle. This is only the tricky part, one of the trickiest part.
Please. I tell you what the notation A1, A2.
So, okay, let me do it here. I am able to reach here, second element and mth element. I am not drawing any extraneous thing, only what wherever I can reach. Okay. So, m nodes I am able to reach, that is what I have written A1. Now, this can reach here and here, sorry, some middle one. In the second stage, twice of these. So, I have written 2 into A1. Okay. But this input, this is also there coming, second port. I am assuming in worst case the second particular input port is already connected. So, if it is connected, it cannot be routed in any other fashion. It has to use one of these switches, has to be consumed in that. Either it is connected from here to here, here to here, or maybe through this one to this, any one of these. So, suppose this is gone, it is already consumed because this path was already taken. So, how many are left? 2 A1 minus 1. Next stage. Okay.
Same thing can happen with other switch also. Same thing can happen with other block also.
This one also.
Yeah.
But you can only set up one path. This is a switch. Okay. So, I have already taken this path. Sorry, for the first one. I have already taken this particular, this is from second one actually. If this has already been taken, I won't be connecting through this switch. No? There can be only one path, unicast. Either I can set it through this or through this. There are many alternate paths. Only one of them can be consumed. If I am already path has been set up through this route, only this will get consumed. So, only one node can get consumed here. So, next one again you will do. This will not expand, this has already been consumed, remember. So, in the third stage is 2 times the A2, these many will be coming, okay. But these nodes can also be reached by some other route also, something like this will be happening. So, these two elements are there which can also get, can reach to these particular nodes. In worst case, those two ports are also occupied. So, two nodes will be gone in that case. So, for example, this is gone and this is gone, this is possible.
Sir, but then if there are other nodes, then we could have considered those nodes also while considering A2.
No, these two other ports cannot reach any other port. See, you have to understand, this can in first stage can only reach here. In second stage, this input port can only reach here and here, cannot reach at these two. In a third stage only they will reach to everywhere. And if I have already consumed, for example, this particular switch for a path, I cannot reach here. Those are anyway excluded. So, every time there is a fresh input port which will come. And this will ensure that there is no conflict with the earlier allotments. So, I am just doing doubling and minus this. So general expression is going to be this. Well, you have to carefully sit down and think about it actually. But that's the only way you can understand. Because unless you have a very big diagram and you start actually doing calculation, start counting, you won't be able to appreciate. You actually can draw a 32 by 32 Bayes network, then you can very well understand that. So try doing a larger Bayes network and try to study them. Then you will appreciate what I am saying. And the only thing is very which is important is this port through this switch can go to here, here and here, but only one of the path will get consumed. I am assuming whatever worst case scenario, that path has been set up by somebody already. So what is not there available to me, I am trying to look at that. And everybody, every path has been set up except the one which I am trying, only one input is free and one output is free. That's the case which we are considering. So in worst case scenario, the middle stage switch, A log 2 n. So how many free nodes how many nodes I should be able to reach in the middle stage? That's the question. So that will be A log 2 n. So put the values here. This is a recursive relation again. Okay. So if you start solving this recursive relation, I can do that actually from here. So A k twice of A k minus 1. So I can now put 2, whatever is the value of AK minus 1. This will be this in turn will be this. And if you keep on doing recursively, keep on solving, you will end up in getting 2 raised to power k minus 1 A1 okay, sum of these two is always equal to k, you have to understand. I am doing that same thing. From there you can verify. This is just every time I am increasing the number. So this will be base counting basically, it is going to count, keep on counting because 2 multiplies and normalizes the exponent. So it is always 2 to the power k minus 2. So this is what should be your relation at the end. So using this, what is a log 2 n? A1 is m, I have already given that constant. A log 2 n is this is m minus and this is nothing but k, so log 2 n minus 1 log 2 n minus 1 log 2 n minus 2. I just replace k by log 2 n and this value is n by 2 m minus this fine. So these many nodes I can reach from the left side or the input side. My switch is completely symmetric construction wise. So if I look at the incoming port or the outgoing port, from there I go backward to the middle stage. So from each outgoing port I should be able to reach to these many same number of elements in the middle stage, free actually elements in the middle stage. These are free elements which I am counting in worst case. Okay, and how many middle elements are there? They are total m Bain's network. Each Bain's network will have n by 2 middle stage elements. Total number of middle stage elements is nm by 2. So which actually implies, if I say 2 of a log 2 n, so number of elements which I can reach from the input port, number of elements which I can reach from output port, I sum all these elements, free elements, which is nothing but 2 a log 2 n. If this value is greater than nm by 2, means what? This is like from this input I am able to reach to these particular ports. From these I am able to reach to these particular free ports. Total number of ports is already known to me, which is nm by 2. So total number of free reachable ports and total number of free reachable ports, if it is more, there are ports available in the middle which are common, which are reachable from left side as well as from the right side. There is some common free port, free middle stage switching elements which are available. That's the meaning. Okay. So for example, I can take a very simple thing and explain this. For example, I have only 4 middle stage elements. This is in general sense. I am able to reach to only one free and from here also one free. So these 3 input lines are not free, these 3 outputs are not free, I cannot set up the connection. So 1 plus 1 is less than 4. I make it 2, for example. Now I can reach here, I can reach here, still I cannot set up the connection. I can reach 2 from left side, 2 from right side, which is equal to middle stage elements. This is the worst case scenario. But suppose I can reach 3 from this side and 3 from this side, and there are only 4 middle stage elements, then you try all combinations, you will find out there is going to be some middle stage elements which are reachable from both sides for all possible scenarios. And if I can find these, I can use these to set up the path. So my switch is strictly non-blocking. I am able to set up the connection without disturbing any earlier connection. So once you solve it, you will get, just place whatever I have done here. In this case, this will be nm by 2 minus n by 4 log 2 n minus n by 4.
Multiplied by 2.
Yes, that I have not done. Fine. So this 2 I can take, this will be nm. So this nm by 2 can be subtracted. So I can remove this thing and this will be.
Sir, it will not cancel
out. Oh, it cannot cancel out. It cannot cancel out.
Here 2 in numerator left hand side, here 1 in denominator, how it cancel?
Oh right, it will become 4, nm by 4. I think that's the way it has to be, sorry. So I can remove this particular thing and this will become 4, and this whole thing I can take on the right side. So here n will cancel, 4 will cancel. So m has to be greater than, I think I have missed out something. Yeah. So this has to be minus a. So m has to be greater than log 2 n minus 1, which technically implies that m is greater than or equal to log 2 n. If this condition is satisfied, I can always find out some free element in the middle stage which can be reached from both sides, and this can be used to set up the connection, and thus switch is strictly non-blocking. Okay. And so cross point complexity in this case will be you have n demultiplexer switches, okay, and they are 1 by log 2 n each one of them. So they require log 2 n cross bars. There are n log 2 n complexity in the demultiplexer side, multiplexer side also same twice, plus the middle stage is going to be n log 2 n. Log 2 n such Bayes network, solve it, your cross point complexity is O n log 2 n square, and that is what is the Cantor network. So with that, I think we finished today. And next class tomorrow, we will be looking into one of the examples of what we call wide sense non-blocking system, where you actually start using an algorithm. If you use a proper algorithm, switch will always remain in non-blocking state. It will never be in the blocking state. Okay. But if you don't, are not careful, you just choose anything haphazardly, you might end up in a blocking state. In this case, irrespective of algorithm, you can always, you are always in non-blocking state. So far, that's what we have done. So, wide sense non-blocking example we will do tomorrow.
Nm by 2 I suppose. Why it should be greater than nm by 2?
The same example. The middle stage, how many elements are there? Middle stages is nm by 2. So, what I can reach from this side? And what I can reach from this side, some of these
number of situations, number of 2 by 2 will be m.
Number 2 by 2 elements.
Switching blocks.
Each Bayes network will have n by 2. And they are such m Bayes element.
Can I do it otherwise? I mean, only half is less than nm by 2.
Half?
No.
I mean, in the sense ki maximum number of networks, what you told earlier, from maximum number of middle stage switches which I can either from the input side or from the output side has to be symmetrical.
Yeah, so I just double that.
In case you don't double it, will you get the same relation?
No, without doubling you can't. See, reachability from this side and reachability from this side. Total sum, if it is greater than whatever is available, there is something which has been counted more than one times, which is common. I am trying to just prove that there is some common element in the middle stage which is free. And if I can reach to that point from here to this side, I can reach from here to also to this side. There is a path available, and I can always use that to set up the connection. It is a reachability analysis technically. I am trying to analyze the reachability.
N by 2 is coming from
Bayes network. You remember that? So this is a 8 by 8 network.
So basically, sir, it is what it is trying to do is that recursive construction of.
There is no recursion here.
Sir, in the middle stage, we have done.
Middle stage is a recursively constructed reengineered
non-blocking.
It's a Bayes network.
And that Bayes network in the middle stage is coming from that rearrangeably non-blocking, recursive iteration, recursive construction.
Yeah.
And then we are getting MC.
Bayes gave the configuration, network is known as Bayes network. You can also do it through recursive construction of using 2 by 2 elements, not 3 by 2 or any other. It is only through 2 by 2. For a specific case only it is a Bain's tetrahedron.